Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we welcome you to our 2023 Jingle Jam. Can I hear a round of applause out here? Oh my God. It's not every Sunday that we get to come here to church experiencing the full breadth and display of God's handiwork, God's creation. Today we're going to see some tap dancing. Who's ready? You're ready? Oh, okay, I'm ready. Some sing-along and joke. Who's ready over here? Oh, yeah. You won't have boring preaching from me, but Pastor Glenn, now, we're going to miss Pastor Glenn's sermons. So everyone say, aww. All right. But without further ado, we welcome you to our service today. My name is Pastor Chris. I'm one of the associate pastors here at St. Joe. And if you look around here, let's just give a special round of applause. There are people who are running sound and slides today. Let's thank them over here. There are people who are going to be dancing over here. Let's thank them in advance. We have the band up here. And we welcome you today. So turn to the person next to you and say, buckle up your seatbelt and get ready. I know, right? Yeah, buckle up. Buckle up, guys. Buckle up. Buckle up. All right. All right. And without further ado, we'll begin with our announcements today. We welcome you to St. Joe. We hope that you can maybe consider this being your church in the future. We are a festive and fun and fruitful and fearless community that tries to make a difference in this world for Jesus. So welcome to church today. Let's start with some announcements.
Jeez, what's going on?
I'm getting ready for Christmas, Glenn. Like all the things. Look at all the things.
Okay, I guess I can see. I've got you got the Jingle Jam.
Jingle Jam. Cookie Walk.
That's coming up the week before Christmas. The choir's doing that.
Longest Night.
Okay, both places.
Baby Jesus.
For Christmas Eve.
For Christmas Eve.
Lots of services.
And my PJs.
For the Y Pajama Christmas party.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got
and
it
the
all.
Time, the clock.
Oh, my clock, yeah. Countdown to noon.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I need that too.
You know, you don't need to do all this.
I didn't?
No.
Are you sure?
I am sure. In fact, if anybody wants to do any part or all of this, all they really need are one of these postcards. One side St. Joe at the Y, one side St. Joe UMC, and we've got plenty for not just you, but all your friends, relatives, acquaintances, neighbors, and colleagues. Christmas time is coming.
It's coming, but this was more fun than the postcard.
Oh no. When we actually do the stuff on the postcard, it's gonna be a great time.
Awesome.
Hello, my name is Austin, and I am the worship leader at St. Joe at the Y.
Hi, I'm Beth. I am a longtime member and also a member of the Chancel Choir here at St. Joe. I want to make sure that everybody knows. Hey, Austin, do you know what's going on today?
I believe it's the cookie walk.
It is totally the cookie walk. Here at St. Joe campus, we are selling cookies to benefit the Chancel Choir. We want your cash or your checks. No credit, please. But the cookies will be on sale until we are all done with them. They're all gone. This helps to benefit things like the Chancel Choir's cantata last weekend, as well as future choir endeavors. Also wanted to make sure everybody knew about our Christmas Eve services, starting with a 10 a.m. service just here at St. Joe in the sanctuary. We have a 4 p.m. service in the gym at the Jackson R. Lehman YMCA. And then also, St. Joe will have services at 7 and 11 as well.
Sounds exciting. Also coming up, we have the longest night services. There'll be one St. Joe at the Y at 6:30 p.m. We'll have various prayer stations, and there'll be worship that I'll be leading. It'll be in the conference room at the JRL YMCA. There will also be one here at St. Joe UMC, which will be at 7 p.m. here in the sanctuary. Also, New Year's Eve, we have one service that'll be in the morning here at St. Joe at 10 a.m. And then also coming up is the countdown to noon. It's going to be a fun New Year's Eve party hosted by Faith in Motion Dance, with lots of dancing, celebrating, bringing in the new year by dropping 2,024 balloons from the walking track at the JRL and a sparkling grape juice toast at noon. The doors will be open at 11:30 a.m. We've got so many exciting things going on here at St. Joe and St. Joe at the Y, and we're so excited that you are here this morning. Welcome to worship.
Please stand with us as we sing Joy to the World.
And pirates, that doesn't match.
But it's Christmas time. We're decking the halls, everybody. See, they get it.
Decking the halls, yes.
Yeah, decking the halls.
Yeah. Well,
my ship has a deck. All ships have decks, you know. Do you get it?
Yeah, you don't understand. Decorate, deck, decorate. That's what decking the halls is.
Ah, we're going to decorate everything from the promenade to the poop deck.
But pirates don't have anything to do with Christmas.
Nothing?
Nothing.
So look at it like this. The disciples were fishermen.
Well, yeah.
So they had boats.
Yes.
And Jesus walked on water.
Well, at one point, yes.
See,
yes.
Now you're getting it. So we're decking the halls. Are you with me, everybody? Come on!
Don't encourage him. Oh, gosh. You going on a cruise? There we go.
We are going on a cruise. I even have a cousin named Gilligan. We might go visit him. That's right. You were batting down the mast. We're doing the hatches and all the other stuff. I don't know. I don't actually know how to sail.
Okay. This isn't going to work. This has nothing to do with Christmas. I'm sorry.
We're just getting started, everybody.
No matter how you decorate this.
See, now you're getting it. Ships have bows.
Bows. Yes, they do. Ships have bows.
My ship has a starboard.
That's the side of the ship. It has nothing to do. There's no star.
I say Christmas has been landlocked for far too long. It's time for liberation.
You're going overboard with this.
Ah, see, that's it. Ah, now you're getting it. Ah. You know, I think Christmas is all about love, don't you?
Yeah, the
like
love.
Love boat.
Oh, no.
The love boat.
Oh, stop.
All right,
No. Okay, let's just drop this.
Okay, drop anchor. I think you should look at the floor, for instance.
Okay.
Just this board right there, yeah?
Right there.
Uh-huh, yeah. Now put the other foot in front of that one. Yeah. Now walk right off the plank while we keep this Christmas going.
I'm not gonna walk the plank. No, I'm leaving, but I'm keeping my eye on you.
You want my eye patch?
No.
Okay. Well, I think there's nothing more that will get you in the Christmas spirit than singing some songs, right? Let's sing some songs. I've got some really good ones in the key of C. You know what? They did get a little bit smudged here. We might be missing a few words, if you know what I mean. But I think we can play a little game that I like to call Deck the Halls Mad Lib. And I need an assistant to come help me because I'm illiterate. Come on up. That's right. We're gonna write right here. So I need some help from the audience to fill in a few missing words. Okay, the first one, we need a plural noun. I hope you know what that means, because I don't. One syllable, plural noun. Anybody, shout it out.
Stars.
Oh, good. Now we're going to be verbin. Two syllables, verbing. Anything.
Jumping.
An adjective, one syllable.
Shiny?
That's two syllables. Strike it. Cold. A noun, two syllables.
Tree.
Puppy.
Okay, like it. All right. Oh, now an animal. Doubling up on the animals. What?
Zebra.
Perfect. And lastly, a noun, one syllable.
Cat.
I heard cat. We got a lot of animals. It's going to be beautiful. Who's ready to sing with me?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 5 golden stars, 4 jumping birds, 3 cold hens, 2 puppy doves, and a zebra in a cat tree. Deep down in your Christmas. Christmas spirit, okay? On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me 5 golden stars, 4 jumping birds, 3 cold hens, 2 puppy doves, and a zebra in a cat tree. That was beautiful! You know, but on second thought, we should probably leave the rest to the professionals.
Did I hear someone talking about me? Hello, how is Roland? It's that time of year I treasure the time for giving.
Wow, give it up for him one more time. What a dance. Who's ready for another game? Yeah, I need two kid volunteers. You right here, perfect. Perfect. All right, there's my two. And bring your parent. You need a parent. All right. Oh, Dad went, oh, you're going. That was good. All right. So you are going to stand right over here, right here, and right here, with your parents behind you. Perfect, okay. Now, here's how it's going to work. You're going to take the ring, you're going to throw it over to the other side, and try and get it on the candy cane. Yeah. But plot twist, you're going to be blindfolded. So put that on. So your parent's going to have to help you and tell you which way you're throwing. Too hard, too soft, to the right, starboard. Forward, yes, thank you. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go! All right, keep it going. Give it up for them, yeah! You didn't make any. I'm sorry. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. You guys made a whole bunch. You're awesome. You both get an eye patch. You thought I was going to say iPad, didn't you? This is a low-budget production. There's that. Thank you one more time. Round of applause for them. That was fantastic. Who's ready for another monologue?
Yeah, you've been out here a long time.
I know, I'm pooped. Is that where the deck comes from?
Why don't you take up shore leave?
Aye, Captain.
I know Tyler means well. He just likes to have fun. I would imagine that every person in here has a different idea of how to celebrate Christmas. Since Jesus was born, Christmas has been celebrated all over the world in all kinds of ways and languages. Some have wooden shoes. Some use a Yule log. Some celebrate with stockings. People all over the world have celebrated the arrival of Jesus Christ. But I think no matter how we celebrate, we can agree that taking time to retell that story is always a wonderful part of Christmas.
This side. The storm will be here soon.
Well, that ship I was watching, do you think it'll make it home before the storm?
It should. Oh, look.
Do you need help from your lighthouse?
It'll come on in a couple of minutes.
I hope so. It's almost Christmas.
Ships don't need this old lighthouse anymore. They've got radar and GPS.
I bet it helps.
Let's finish this tree. Come on.
What's it like to be way out there on a boat in a storm?
Dark.
Is that all?
It's cold. Your eyes are just searching for any kind of light that you can focus on. Gotta get the lights.
That doesn't sound like fun. It's Christmas. Christmas is supposed to be bright and cozy.
Well, the first Christmas wasn't always bright and definitely not cozy.
When Jesus was born?
Yes. God's people weren't always having it good. But God promised to send a rescuer. So they always were on the lookout for a distant light that they knew would come. Now, in this dark time, there was an ordinary girl named Mary. One day, an angel appeared before her, and the angel said she was blessed by God. Mary must have been pretty surprised because the angel told her, "Don't be afraid." The angel told her she would have a baby, God's son.
Baby Jesus.
That's right. And Mary trusted God. And she said, "May it happen just as you said." All right. So, of course, Mary and her husband Joseph had to get ready to have a baby. But when Mary was just about to have a baby, things got complicated. They were told everyone must go back to their hometown to be counted and pay lots of money.
Not fair.
Well, Mary and Joseph had to make that long trip back to Bethlehem. But when they got there, that little town of Bethlehem was packed. There was no room for them to stay anywhere. So they ended up staying in a place where animals live. Can you imagine that?
You're right. It wasn't bright or cozy.
Well, I'm sure they tried to make the best of it. Mary wrapped him tightly and put him in the animal trough. God's son had been born. The light of the whole world was sleeping on a bed of hay.
Is it on?
It is, exactly. God could have shouted the amazing news to kings and rich people, broadcast it far and wide, even brighter than that old lighthouse. But instead, God sent an angel to some lonely shepherds outside of town. Those shepherds were just sitting there, keeping warm by the fire, when a brilliant angel showed up and told them, "I bring you good news. It will bring great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. Here's how you will know I am telling you the truth. You will find the baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." And then a whole angel choir showed up to sing about it. "May glory be given to God in the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth."
And then the shepherds ran to find Jesus, right?
Mm-hmm.
I bet some of the sheep went along.
Exactly. And when the shepherds saw Jesus, they were so excited, they told everyone they met.
This is one of my favorite parts. Tell about the star.
So when Jesus was born, some wise scholars far to the east saw a special star in the sky, and they knew it meant a king had been born. So they set out across the desert to find him. They followed that star for months and months and months.
And they brought special presents for Jesus.
Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. When the wise men found Jesus, they gave him their gifts and they worshiped him.
I love that story.
Me too, sweetheart. Jesus was a bright light in the darkness for God's people then and for us. It does.
Is it time?
I think it is.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Jesus is a light, no matter how stormy your life gets. Jesus is a gift to all. I hope that your family takes time to decorate a tree, a table, the whole house this Christmas. And as you do, remember that you are celebrating God's great gift and his love for you. It is the greatest gift ever, eternal life through Jesus. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for all the excitement at this time of year. Show us this season how much you love us and care for us. It is the greatest present we could ever receive. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You know, Mary, I think this went really well.
I do too.
I hope we can navigate our way back to Jesus this Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Yes, and I got it.